Hey guys, welcome back to another Swisters in One video. And today, we're back in X-Plane. Today, we are at Dubai. This is most probably one of my favorite airports with the CRJ, which is quite a little bit of a contrary to Dubai because it's called the worst plane by many travelers. Today, I'm going to talk about the CRJ 200 a bit more and generally about the CRJ lineup by Bombardier. Now, yeah, maybe some basic facts. This is from the Canadian plane manufacturer Bombardier, which you can see right here. It's a great plane manufacturer. In fact, I'm actually kind of a fan of Bombardier. I like their planes. I'd even like to fly the CRJ 200. That's my personal opinion on that, but we're going to talk about that later. Now, the CRJ 200 had its first flight in 1991 and was introduced in 1992 with Lufthansa. Lufthansa still uses some CRJ planes to fly, for example, from Frankfurt to Stuttgart, for example. Now, obviously, this is a regional jet, and as you can see, it's very small. It kind of does look smaller than it actually is. I mean, this thing seats 50 passengers. That is quite a lot, especially when you think about the fact that this plane kind of has like two windows. Like, honestly, this looks like a bigger private jet, which it kind of is after all. Right, so here is the cockpit. This is quite an old jet, 1991, but we still feature a few bigger screens. I mean, this is obviously not an obsolete plane yet, even though the Atom makes this plane look very dirty and used. Obviously, we have a pilot next to us, which is using a Sennheiser headset, which is quite unusual. Hello, demon. Maybe we can take a look into the cabin as well. This is what the cabin looks like. And yeah, we can already see why people might not prefer to be flying this plane. Now, first of all, the cabin in this plane seems very, very dark. Maybe that's because of me. I have flown the CRJ 200 before in X-Plane. Now, this will actually turn on the emergency lights, but that might help us see a bit more. You know, those lights, those actually don't help at all. So this has a 2x2 configuration, and you can already see this is a very, very small plane. Another thing is that the window configuration is super weird. The windows are not too small. That's not the biggest problem, but the actual problem is that the windows are very, very low. I've read some reviews online and asked some people that have actually flown the CRJ 200, and they all said the window is kind of made for 6-year-olds. This cabin is quite dark, isn't it? And also, obviously, it's cozy. Most probably a tall person will have the biggest problem with this. I mean, actually, this plane is used in America the most, and in America, you have the most overweight people. So now, to be quite honest, I have never flown with the CRJ planes in real life, since I live near a very, very big airport, so there's simply no demand for any connecting flights, unless I want to visit some smaller towns, which I, you know, usually have never done before. So yeah, there was never really a demand to fly the CRJ 200, but I would love to try it out. And also, there is no business class or anything like that. There's only premium economy. Now, maybe let's fly this plane first before further going into it. Now, again, this plane is not too old and it's quite safe as well. So obviously, there are no concerns about things like those. And when I'm scrolling through the accidents reports of this airliner, there are only one of those crashes where there's only one fatality. This plane is not deadly at all. I'm sure it's polite as well, since it's Canadian. Now, what I've also noticed is that this add-on is super dirty, especially the fuselage. I mean, look at this. Jesus Christ. Yeah, you should clean this plane more often, right? Now, at the same time, there are planes that are more, well, attractive. I've already talked about this. This plane is very uncomfortable for passengers, and it's also not modern. I mean, this thing does not have auto speed or something like that. The throttle has to be controlled manually, which, for example, the Embraer jets have. So, the Embraer jets are a lot more attractive, obviously. This only has Cat 2 ILS certification, so this thing obviously cannot perform an auto land, which is very bad for foggy landings and stuff. So this is not a modern plane, so it kind of makes sense that no one wants to buy this anymore. And right now, a lot of CRJ 200s are being retired, again, with Embraer ERJ jets that are more modern. And also, there are more CRJ modern CRJ jets as well, actually, from Bombardier. like the CRJ700. That one is quite more modern and quite more fuel efficient as well. But in my opinion, like, this seems like a, you know, cute jet to fly as a pilot, you know, but maybe not as a passenger. But I would not prefer to fly this thing professionally, since obviously you make less money on regional flights, which is a whole nother story. Now, a CRJ costs around $30 million, which obviously sounds much, but that's totally nothing compared to other planes, obviously, even though there are no CRJs produced anymore, and obviously there are no orders coming in. I'm pretty sure you can somehow get a used CRJ200 though, as there are still some airlines using it and retiring it as well. Now, shut up. I remember that I have never actually had an emergency in this one. Like an X-plane, I mean, obviously. How do you distinguish this thing? Help. Oh no, we're going down. Oh no, we are now over the ocean. How did that happen? There's a glitch in the matrix. Now, let's land. Oh god, oh god, oh god. Oh, shoot. Okay, that was kind of a crash, but now we can actually exit the cockpit with this door. There we go. Very nice. That's nice for escaping and stuff, especially in the case of a hijack or something. You can easily escape the plane. Obviously, you want to be on ground for that. Now, also, opening the general aircraft doors is quite a smooth experience. You know, I like planes that have built-in doors. I also like the Ryanair 737 configuration, since they have that have actual integrated stairs. Now let's go to St. Bartholomew and see how this plane performs on small runways. Alright, so here we are in St. Bartholomew. We might want to close the doors, this thing as well. Let's go, you can do it, you can do it. Okay, rotate. We need to rotate actually now. Oh yes, alright. Even though this was quite a late takeoff, I kind of expected more. I mean, the 737 takes off even faster. But yeah, that was acceptable, I guess. We did not crash, and that's kind of all what counts, isn't it? Now let's actually try to land here as well. Now, by the way, I've actually seen planes come in from the other side of the runway, which is kind of interesting. I actually thought that only runway 10 was allowed to be used for landing, not the opposite, runway 28. So yeah, that's kind of interesting. Let's actually land, right? I mean, St. Bartholomew doesn't have the shortest runway. I mean, Lucla is shorter, and even Courchevel is shorter than that. Oh wait, autopilot was activated. That's not good. Okay, let's land. Oh my goodness, that was hard. Brakes on max effort. Same with the reverse thrusters. And this plane is actually not able to stop. We are absolutely overrunning. And that is something that I've noticed before. The CRJ is not a quick stopper. I think I've also said this before. But here you can see the landing was even right before the runway, because I knew that this plane was gonna fail. We were not really fast. I mean, 120 knots, that is really not fast. I mean, the 737 or something is perfectly able to land and take off from this airport. Now yes, CRJ200, it's time to take off on a carrier. Let's release the brakes and launch ourselves into the skies. Now maybe a little bit of flaps, those might help. There we go. Oh yes. Now that was almost another fail again. This was a perfect takeoff. I mean, even an A380 is perfectly able to take off of there. Now coming back to the topic whether the CRJ deserves to be hated that much or not, I think, you know, it's kind of a crappy regional jet indeed, or the Nickelback of the skies, as I've read it somewhere. I mean, it kind of is at this point. It's not the best plane. And also what I forgot to mention was that actually the windows here, even for the pilots, are very, very small. You are barely able to see out of this thing as well. This thing has not good visibility, both for pilots and for passengers. I do like to fly it though, honestly, but it's not a comfortable aircraft for both passenger and pilot. I think it deserves this hate because it's kind of very small and it's not practical. So yeah, guys, thank you for watching today's video, and I'll see you tomorrow. As always, good night.